But the problem was the song we wanted to do didn't have the sound that reflected our brand at that
moment. It didn't bring out it wasn't representing it the way you wanted it to.
Exactly. Mm. So what happened, we did a song that didn't do well.
Okay.
And that was, you know, maybe I think our downfall, I think.
What was the name of the song?
Yeah. After that song, we did it. We did the video, a very nice video. It got played here and there, but eventually it didn't work out like we expected.
Okay.
One thing for sure is, I felt like the production was good. It was professional, but the producer did not take into account our brand.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah.
I know this is the kind of music you like playing at your gigs. So when I'm giving you a collection of audios, I'll not give you music that you won't play at your gig. Exactly. I'll give you more.
Yeah.
What you do.
Yeah. Exactly.
So I landed into Fruity Loops. At that moment, it was Fruity 3.5, I guess.
Okay.
Someone. So from that moment, that's when I started playing around with it. And, you know, eventually the next project I did was a beat like I had developed on that software.
Oh, you started with Fruity.
Yeah.
And like self-taught, basically, self-taught. You are just going into Fruity, trying things out.
Exactly.
Wow.
And trust me, it's not a good beat. The idea was great, you know? And from there, we did a song, and I did it with one of the guys from the group, and it was an anthem. I liked it. We all liked it. It was one of the most successful songs I ever did. The name of the song is... Oh, I never sent you that song. It's called Hanini.
Oh, okay.
No. It's called Hard to Get.
Wow. So that was like your first production after you've been messing with Fruity Loops and doing all this. And now you're trying out your first song kind of, because it was a better representation of what you wanted. Like it was coming from you. It kind of brought the real you out that was supposed to be, you know what I mean?
Exactly. And actually that was one song that was rejected by one of the producers we went to work with as a group.
Okay. Somebody had already said, no, this one can't work.
Yeah, we had already presented this as an idea, but it's too cliche.
It goes that sometime. And listen, there is a lot of your type of singer, songwriter, and producers who you turn into production because what you wanted, you know what I mean? It's not, other producers are not bringing it out the way you want. So partly out of frustration, you start like this. And then you end up like, you know what? I might as well just go and do this myself, innit?
Yeah.
Inspiration, my man. It's a hard road, innit?
Exactly.
Yeah, let's listen to this one. One Night Stand. This was a tune. It's a tune. One Night Stand. That's a tune, my man. That one was well received, right? I know, because I'm one of them. When I'm out there doing what I do, it's always on rotation here and there. That's I can guarantee you that goes. Listen, now you're into production, right? Because you've worked with a lot of people. You're like one of those. Your name is always in the conversation, but it's not. That's just me. Kind of like a bit underrated. Like if your work is to go with, right? That's just me. I might be wrong, right? Because hey, to each their own. Minda Semaiva, because you kind of have, excuse me, you kind of have your style. That's what I was saying. It's really, it's pro club, it's everything, it's a nice, good vibe and all that. But in the cut, you have the numbers like Mdogo Mdogo or whoever, which are like, you know what I mean? I can stand on my two, if you know what I mean, if we get to that, right? And then the names you've worked with. You've worked with my man, family, you've worked with Chief Tane. Right?
Yeah.
Chieftain family. You've worked with Ramosh. There's Ramosh. There's big up the general Kidis Jembe in there. I've seen a number of you with Kidis Jembe. Just to name a name, can you just give us a few more names of the people you've worked with from back then to right now?
Yeah, basically, it sounds like you've already said most of them.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked with Raj, that song you started with. Raj is really good. He's known for his song called Obe, Obe Baba. You know?
There's a Kisi, vibe or something. Yeah, I know about that one. Yeah, somewhere in the locker, yeah, that one, yeah.
Yeah, he's really good. Actually, I've worked with more artists, but some of those songs never saw the light of the day. Kenya to Kolashi, they are working together. We have that problem. Like, from Noneo time, when I was doing Hard to Get, we had a producer who was supposed to do that song, and he was like, let's wait for Gopa to Malizana with their swing. And the moment they're saying that, I love swing, I love that kind of music. Again.
I get you.
Yeah, so I think I have more songs unreleased out there than I have released.
Okay.
I'm thinking, I think this is where I can tell them, let's work together. Let's think about the future. Let's stop thinking about the small.
I think there's the ego thing behind the scenes. Somebody, you know what I mean? Like ego tripping. Yeah. Okay. I know for a certain, like I can speak for a certain, there are two or three artists here in Europe who like they're eager to work with you. I know that for a certain. There are two or three. I'm not gonna bring them out anyway. That are eager to work with you, and I know you've worked with some other artists, Afrobeat artists outside Kenya internationally.
There's one in your area. It's called Gambino.
I linked up with Gambino. He was telling me that you shout out Gambino. That's family.
And Akubo ATL in the building.
Yeah, Akubo ATL in the building. Stand up.
Yeah, he's actually from Gambia.
Mm-hmm.
He has Gambia, but he's based in the UK. And he, the first time we worked with him was, actually, I met him through Chieftain.
That's family right there, Chieftain. Shout out to Chieftain. Kahawa Gedurai Wendani, the city of angels. Stand up.
Our Gafe.
Gafe. I'm telling you, just to say about, like, Gafe, you know, this quarantine time, And then there was Mother's Day, or so yesterday was Mother's Day, right? So you kind of like, yeah, shout out to all the mothers out there, keeping us going and all that. Yeah, so I was just remembering how my mom's used to be a champ. You know, Gaffey, when we were playing outside, right? I'd do something, and then when I come in, my dad is coming for me. Oh, what did you do outside? My mom is like, hey, relax, man. Why are you doing that? It wasn't just him. It was the other boys. And then my dad's still going for me, like, see, they're setting you up. They just, come on, man, leave the young man alone. I was like, oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, shout out, Gaffey. Yeah.
Trust me, you remember the roads. There's too many people out there right now.
Yeah,
the population has...
Things have changed. Things have changed. Yeah, things have really changed, right? And you've also worked with Sonny Foreman.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Msani.
Yeah, shout out to him, and we are glad he recovered from COVID.
Yeah,
I hope you've talked.
No. I spoke to him. I knew it was going on, but we had, I just remembered him in my prayers and all that. But I link up with Msani Foreman. We'll definitely link up. And on that note, let's go to one of your other productions, It's one of those things that not a lot of people know, like you can put it like that. That's some vibes right there. That's some vibes. Now talk to me. One silly generic question. You gotta get this out of the way. What is your so now as a producer? Let's go to the nitty gritty. What do you use? What's your tools or trade now as a producer like? What's your tool or trade right now?
I started with FL, so I'm loyal. I'm still on FL. And I Reason 5, and Cubase.
Okay.
That's it. There's nothing else I use.
Wow. Just those three. You're loyal to FL Studios, isn't it?
Yeah. Took me out from getting bad beats, so I got to stay.
Yeah, but so as a producer, though, right, what's your process when you're thinking, when you're putting together a song as a producer, what's your process? How do you go about it?
Well, as a producer, producing for someone else or for myself?
No, let's start with for yourself. Oh, yeah, you lot do that. Let's start with for yourself.
Okay, for myself, there has to be inspiration first. Yeah, I'll just make a beat for me and just jump on it for the sake of it. So mostly my songs come from my ideas. Like, let's say I have this melody. No, I have this topic and I get the melody then.
Mm-hmm.
And then from the melody, it comes up, brings out the beat. That's why when you listen to most of my songs, they like sound organic, you know, they're not forced. Because it started from there.
The melody, conceptual,
the idea, and then the instrumental. It's not like I had this instrumental and I was like, what can I say about this?
You're trying to fit inside the pockets of an instrumental. No. It's the other way
it's
around.
It's not me forcing myself into an instrumental.
Mm.
It's my melodies inspiring the instrumental.
Okay. And also the lyrics, basically, most of the times, right?
Yeah, the lyrics will determine the mood of the beat.
All right.
Yeah, so that's for me as the artist.
Mm-hmm.
As a producer, I can work either way. I can have a beat and give you as the artist and you'll come up,
mm-hmm.
give me a nice chorus or maybe a halfway nice chorus, then you work on it and it becomes nice. Or I can just give you and you do your thing.
Okay. So, which one do you like, producing for other people and producing for yourself? Which one do you enjoy?
I used to enjoy both, but the reason why I produce for myself is because I told you already.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, sometimes I make beats and I like them to be done by other people, but sometimes unapata sio nampatia dope beats
anayua. I've had those situations.
So sometimes you have a really nice beat, but give it to somebody, they marry it in the other way.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you give them a beat and they don't really digest the beat before they write. They just force a previous song they had written onto the beat, so it sounds off.
Okay.
And the reason why I still record on my beats is because sometimes I find it someone didn't do justice to this beat.
Mm-hmm.
And like you meet really nice artists, you want to show them, you want to add your ideas on the beat and they like, no, I know what I'm doing.
Producers can be particular. You can be particular. Some artists in general, from even painters to whatever, you can be particular. So you basically, maybe you're allowed for that. Now.